हेलो सोनम, गुड इवनिंग।
गुड इवनिंग सर।
हाउ आर यू?
यस सर, आई एम फाइन। एंड व्हाट अबाउट यू सर?
वेल, आई एम ग्रेट एज यूजुअल। यू कैन सी मी?
या दैट्स गुड।
या सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कवर ऑफ 10 वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड 10 कॉमनली यूज फ्रेजल वर्ब्स विच वी नो अबाउट but we hardly use them in our daily conversation. So today we are going to talk about them, right?
Oh, sir. Okay, right. Sir, okay.
So okay, what sir. I will do, I will tell you phrasal verb, its meaning, one sentence from my side, and I will ask you to tell me one more sentence. Okay?
Okay, okay.
This sir. Is how we will go. So first phrasal verb is on account of, means because of.
In Hindi,
yes, on account of. Ki wajah se. For example, on account of my father's effort, on account of my father's effort, I'm able to complete my education. Like this. Now, can you please tell me, unmute yourself. Can you please tell me one sentence?
Okay,
Pick a sentence
sir.
Will do.
Okay, sir, okay. On account of corona, I am unable to join my coaching classes.
Very good. On account of COVID-19, I am unable to join my coaching classes.
Yes.
All right. Very well. Well, next phrasal verb is behind the bars. Behind the bars
behind
means
the bar.
To put someone into prison. To put someone into jail. Kisi ko jail mein kaid kar dena. And sentence can be formed like this, that criminals should be kept behind the bars.
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Can you please tell me one sentence?
Yes, sir. Vijay Mallya should be kept in behind the bars.
Okay. Very nice.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. The third phrasal verb is beat about the bush. Beat about the bush means
to
avoid coming to the point, but talk something nonsense. ठीक है? घुमा फिर अगर बातें करना, सीधे point पर आकर बात ना करना. And sentence can be formed like this, that my old friend always beats about the bush.
Okay, sir. Okay. When I talk to my parents about money, they beat about the bush.
Okay, they beat about the bush. All right, they
yes,
avoid
sir.
To come on the point. All right.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yeah, next phrasal verb is by leaps and bounds. By leaps and bounds means
by leaps
rapidly.
And bounds.
Yeah, rapidly, speedily. Okay, bahut tezi se.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, and we can say that the news that I got 90% mark in examination spread by leaps and bounds.
Yes, sir. We can say, sir, like this, our economy is growing by leaps and bounds.
Very good. Very nice. Well, next phrasal verb is burst into laughter. Burst into laughter means start to laugh. And sentence has padna. Sentence can be formed like this. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Whenever my friends tell joke in the class, we burst into laughter. Now, can you tell me one sentence?
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. When I talk about my childhood to my students, they burst into laughter.
Okay. Yes. Childhood days are so sweet.
Yes, sir. Yes,
well,
sir.
Next phrasal verb. Next phrasal verb is awaiting for us. That is break into tears. Break into tears means start crying. Okay.
Okay, sir.
And yeah,
break
we can say
tears.
Sentence. Yes. We can say sentence that when I heard the news of my friend's mother demise, I broke into tears.
Yes, sir. Yes, when I go far from my mom, I break into tears.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah. Next special verb is burn the midnight oil. Burn the midnight oil. It means
yes, sir.
To work till late night. Der raat tak kaam karna. And a sentence can be formed that if you want to become successful in life, you have to burn the midnight oil.
Okay.
Can you tell me one sentence?
We can say that. Yes, sir. Our soldiers burn the midnight oil, so we can sleep without any tension.
Very good. So that we can sleep without any.
Yes.
Tension or problems.
Yes, tension.
Very
tension.
Good.
Problems.
Yes. Next special verb is in any case, mean any condition.
Any case.
Many parents force their children to get more marks in examination in any condition or in any case. Now it's your turn. Tell me one sentence.
Okay, sir. Yes, sir. I will have to make this session fantastic in any case.
Okay, thank you so much. I know that was not the only sentence.
Yes, sir.
It was really what you wanted. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Well, another phrasal verb is on cloud nine. It means a situation in which you are very much
on
happy.
On cloud nine.
Yes, on cloud nine. And sentence, bahut zyada khush ho jana. And sentence can be formed like this.
Okay, sir.
When I heard the news that I got selected in government job, I was on cloud nine. Now can you tell me
okay,
one sentence?
Sir. And yes, sir. When I got the news about your success, I'm on cloud nine.
Okay, I was on cloud nine. You can say like that.
I was on cloud nine.
All right. Well, the next
yes,
and the last phrasal verb is come to an end. Come to an end means to finish something,
come
to complete
to
something.
End.
Yes, come to an end means to finish something
okay.
or to complete something. And we can say that
okay,
after 50 minutes, a very critical surgery came to an end. Now, can you tell me one sentence?
Can you repeat, sir, please?
Yes. That is, come to an end. Means to finish something or to end something.
Yes, sir.
And sentence can be formed like this.
Okay, sir.
That after 50 minutes, a very critical surgery came to an end.
Came to an end. Okay, sir. And after some time, this is the come to an end of sentences.
You can say that after 5 minutes, session will come to an end.
Yes, sir.
Please repeat.
Yes, sir. After 5 minutes, session will come to an end.
Very good. Very well. So now you did a very good try,
okay.
And I can say that you are improving. Gradually. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yes.
Yes.
And trust me for one thing, that you would become very good English speaker. Not immediately, but definitely.
Yes, sir.
Just keep practicing.
Yes, sir. I will
stay together. Yes.
Okay, sir.
Keep practicing. Okay.
Okay?
Yeah. So this is the end of the session from my side. Thank you so much for joining. See you in the next session.
Thank you so much. Okay.
Bye. Have a nice day. Take care.
Thank you, sir. Bye.